in a freaking blizzard yesterday at the top of Mount Rogers in Grayson Highland Park, and snow was coming at me sideways. And if my parents didn't come through for me and get me that last room at that hostel, I would have been SOL big time. Mom, Dad, I love you so much. Thank you for looking out for me. It was a good night's stay. They fed me like a champion. I did laundry. Suzanne and James at Suffy Lodge, you guys are the best. Thank you for the hospitality. Got a great night's sleep. You guys fed me like enough for 5 days worth. That's why I got good legs right now going. But beautiful day. It's still cold out, but I'm able to log some miles. Just plucking along, trying to get to the next town. But thought I'd give you guys an update on the weather. I don't have a lot of big up and downs today, I don't think. So I can put some miles in. Anyway, hope everybody's doing well. Bye-bye. About 27, 28 miles when it's all said and done. I got another half a mile to do so, but there's a train track that way. I just came from back there. But look up at the top up there, there's a farm. I was going to stay at one of these farms. They have Alpaca Farm. I think it's that one over there, but they're full. But I am going to go into town and relax at an inn and get some Mexican food. But today was a tough day. It wasn't so much up and down, but I guess I described it like to my mom and my dad. If you broke a bottle of glass and all the shards of glass that you had, and you made those shards of glass the size of rocks and then put them on the trail, that's basically what you're walking on. And it's like they're so random, it's not flat, so I don't know what's the lesser of my evils, going up or down or walking on freaking hard rock for 28 miles. But I want to get off my feet, that's for sure. I want to put some Mexican food in my belly. That's what I'm gonna do. Someone told me that I look like El Guapo today. But look at that thing. Got some color in there. It doesn't itch anymore, my beard, but it's freaking growing. I look like I'm a hillbilly. Alright. Well, that's it for now.
stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadow.
Oh, well, I'm finishing up a 30-mile day. And I'm going to go across that bridge right there. That's what I'm doing. This will make it 30 miles. Long freaking day. Slack packed all day today. Someone took my backpack. And I did 30 miles without having to carry half a human in my back. What a blessing. Skillet Hostel, which is in a church, in a kind of a renovated church into a hostel. Mango runs it. He has been a blessing. I've been able to slack pack the last 2 days. I did a 30 miler without my backpack. And then he picked me up. And then this morning I'm slack packing to the next place I'm going to bunker down for the night. But after almost 6 weeks of walking, not carrying half a human has been a blessing. but I'm right here at this lake. Look at this lake, kind of cool. I'm really trying to put in the miles. My legs are underneath me. Last night Mongo, without even soliciting, hooks up this machine where I could soak my feet in Epsom salt. So my feet got a nice little massage and soaking last night. I feel good. But today's the first day breaking the weather where it's actually been really nice. It's supposed to be in the high 70s, mid to high 70s today, which is weird because yesterday when I started out, it was in the 30s and my feet were freezing, my hands were freezing. And it looks like we've gotten a break from this cold weather. But now we're going to be dealing with another element where you got to be pretty meticulous with getting your water at every water stop, because they're basically you're going to be sweating your butt off and you're going to need it. But I'm probably going to finish up at mile mark 630 today. I did go over the 600 mile mark. I am proud of myself to making it this far. I've met so many people in the hostels I stayed in, and everybody kind of has their why of why they're doing this. And as you guys all know, my why is nothing other than to help raise money for my wrestling program. And the cool thing last night, with the help of some people, I think Danny Ware, came in there, Ken Chirto, my former assistant wrestling coach, Olympian in 1988. They ended up making some donations last night that pushed it up over 25,000. I am so appreciative. I'm so blessed with having people follow me and contribute to our program. I hope you guys like the video of why I'm actually doing this, why I'm raising money. It's true, I got a big heart for my guys, my team, my school, my community. And you know, the more money I raise, the more people I'm gonna affect. That's the bottom line. If people are asking me why, what too much is too much, no, every bit of money that I'm gonna be raising is gonna affect somebody. It's going right back into helping and giving to kids that need it. could benefit from it, and I want to affect them. So it's never enough. So you guys that are still on the fence about wanting to commit and make a donation or a pledge, go do it. If it's a penny, listen, I'll be more than grateful. If you can do more, do more. And along the way, I've only been challenged once by Doug Libertor, and he challenged me to do a 30 miler, and I did it. And I did it the day after he asked me. And you know what? I did a 30 miler yesterday, and my legs are good. Who's gonna challenge me to do the next one? 35, 40? Don't think I won't do it. I'll do it, especially if you're gonna affect my wrestling program by donating. I'll do it. So I look forward to seeing somebody step up to the plate. Maybe do a $2,193 and a dime, and do something. Ask me to do something cool, I'll go do it. But can't wait to get to the halfway point. The halfway point is a cool spot where you got a down half gallon of ice cream. And that's my dad. He and I love the ice cream. We're gonna, I'll probably share some stories of my dad and I when I was going through college eating ice cream. So I'm looking forward to that. But I hope everybody's having a great Tuesday. I'm having a really good day today. It's nice and sunny. I'm not having to deal with the elements. So keep the support coming. Keep the encouragement coming. Really appreciate everybody. And I am out for now. By the way, you can comment on my beard too. I'm going to grow this dang thing until I can start braiding it. Look at it, I got some gray in there too. Anyway, bye for now.
Yeah.